In this video, we're going to be looking at the Dell Latitude series. This is the E-series laptop. This is model number 6510. I've discovered a common problem with the Latitude series. This may affect all the Dell series laptops, and that is trying to boot up off of what they call a external serial ATA or external SATA cable. So this is an external SATA cable where you have external SATA here, and on the other end you have your power as well as your data that you plug into your drive. So plug it into here. And now you can boot this drive here as an internal hard drive, or in this case an external drive. Either case, the BIOS sees it and sees it right off the bat. It doesn't need to, Windows doesn't need to install any drivers or anything. Any OS needs to install any drivers right from the BIOS. So one of the common problems is when you go into the setup menu or the boot menu on your system, you don't actually see the eSATA boot up option. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just started up this laptop. F12 is the button to go to the boot options. And once booted up, sorry for the glare there, just move that a little down, you'll see here it says CD, Windows Manager, BIOS, and Diagnostics. It doesn't actually give you the option to choose the eSATA port. Similarly, it doesn't give you the option to use a USB. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to power this off. We're going to plug in a USB drive. And we're going to power it on. Once we power this on, we're going to then go into F12, which is the boot options. And now we see in this option the option to boot off of the USB storage device. Now this is common. In the system, you can go in there and you can tell it to boot off the USB drive. Now it's there on that menu. When you go into the BIOS, when you actually go into the setup option, I'll do that now just to show you where that option is. So on the system, you are either going to press F12 or F10. I don't recall which one it is. Let me just have a look here. Let's try F2. So when you press F2, one of the options here is boot sequence. In this boot sequence, you have the options over here and over here. So we have diskette, so your floppy drive, your internal hard drive, your USB, your CD, or DVD, and then your onboard NIC. Where is the external serial ATA? It's not actually listed there. So although I don't have the USB drive plugged in right now, it still shows me the option here. So this is what the confusing part is that how do you boot off of eSATA? How do you boot off of this? Well, the option for eSATA doesn't actually appear in here until you plug this drive in. So we'll go ahead and power this off again. And now we'll plug in the eSATA into the side port. Now the eSATA is a combination of eSATA as well as USB, so you can use it. You can use that as a standard USB port as well. Okay, so now it's in there, and I'm going to power it up. Now this is a solid state drive that I'm booting off of, so you're not going to hear the spinning of the drive or anything like that. So I'm going to choose F12. When I choose F12, you'll now see it says eSATA HDD, eSATA hard drive. So I can now boot off that drive. Let's go ahead and power down again. Once we power down, we're going to power back up. We're going to press F2 to go into the BIOS. sequence in the BIOS, we can then go to the boot sequence. And we now see eSATA HDD. So this is a fairly common common misunderstanding with the Dell laptop, that the eSATA port is not always there. And the reason why it's not always there, because it's not plugged in. Unlike the USB drive, may it be plugged in or not, it's listed in that menu. So that's a bit of a confusing part. Now, speaking of the eSATA port, I will tell you that this model here, this is the E6510, the eSATA port sends out a voltage of 5 volts as well as 12 volts. So that's very important if you're trying to power a 3.5-inch drive. So after doing some research, I found out that the eSATA port has two different voltages, first of all. And two, if you're powering a 2.5-inch drive, it will work perfectly fine on any laptop. That takes 5 volts. Now, if you want to power a 3.5-inch drive, you will need the full 12 volts. So depending on your laptop, you do have to check if that that laptop supports 12 volts. So that concludes this video. If you have any questions, please do post it. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching.